Hello guys, Dhananjay here and welcome back to a new video. And just in case if you do not know, Xiaomi increased prices of two of their devices, Redmi Note 5 Pro 4GB RAM variant and the Mi TV 55 inches. Earlier, the 4GB RAM variant of the Redmi Note 5 Pro costed us around 13,999 or exact 13,999, but that's increased by 1000 rupees and the Redmi Note 5 Pro will cost you 14,999 henceforward. The Mi TV 55 inches costed around 39,999 earlier, but the price is increased by 5,000 rupees and that will cost you 44,999 now. That's a huge price hike in my opinion. And these are the only two devices whose price is increased and no other device's price is increased. And Xiaomi posted about this everywhere like Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. No, they don't have Instagram. They did post it on Facebook and Twitter and people were obviously not happy. And no one is ever going to be happy with a price hike of such a great product. 14,000 rupees was a perfect price in my opinion for the Redmi Note 5 Pro, but they increased it by 1,000 rupees. These are some of the comments which were present on their Facebook post. First comment says that I was confused if I should buy Redmi Note 5 Pro or Asus Zenfone Max Pro. Thanks to this post, I know exactly what I'm going to buy. So basically he's saying that instead of Redmi Note 5 Pro, he'll end up buying the Asus Zenfone Max Pro, which is another device which comes with Snapdragon 636 processor and other great things. And that's a great threat to the Redmi Note 5 Pro. And that device is priced at 11,000 rupees for the 3GB RAM variant and 13,000 rupees for the 4GB RAM variant, which is 2,000 rupees less as compared to Redmi Note 5 Pro. And is the price difference justifiable when it comes to Redmi Note 5 Pro? That's going to be a tough choice now. Wait for my comparison, or that if I have already made it, that will be linked in the I button over there. And the next comment is the one which we are going to discuss as well. Tax is for all. Obviously, taxes are implemented for every single company, not just Xiaomi. Then why the hell you just increased the price? Okay, then why the hell you increase price of only two devices which are popular? Now we can totally see what is your strategy and blah 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 other stuff. Like he went on saying a lot of stuff. And this is the doubt that I have as well. Why only two devices? Why not Redmi 5, which will cost you 9,000 rupees? Another great device with Snapdragon 450 processor. The Mi TV 32 inch will cost you just 14,000 rupees. Mi TV 32 inches is a cheaper device as compared to the Redmi Note 5 Pro now. Why not price hike on those devices? Like that's kind of surprising, because when it comes to Redmi Note 5 Pro 6GB RAM variant, I can understand that that device was already a little bit overpriced. I won't say overpriced, but according to Xiaomi standards, that device was priced little like on the higher side as compared to the 4GB RAM variant. So I can understand them not increasing the price of Redmi Note 5 Pro 6GB RAM variant. But why not 32 inch variant or the 43 inch variant of the Mi TV? These are some of the doubts that I have as well. And if you are wondering why did Xiaomi increase the prices of their devices, then that's justifiable as well, because government imposed taxes on all the PCBs which were imported from other countries. If you manufacture PCBs in India, then that tax is not payable. But if you import from China or from other countries the PCBs, then you have to pay 5% extra tax. And this was done since 1st April 2018. Many people ask me why they did not announce it earlier, or why they did not hike the price by 1st April itself. Then I can totally understand that, because maybe they had imported stock of April month beforehand only, so they had all the PCBs. Or I can totally understand Xiaomi or any other big company for that matter taking few weeks to decide whether they should increase prices of their devices or not, because 500 rupees is a big thing in India. People who were going to buy the Redmi Note 5 Pro over Asus Zenfone Max Pro M1 smartphone may not buy the same device once again because the price is increased by 1000 rupees. And I can surely say this, that 1000 rupees is a big deal for many people. I'm not sure if you understand this or not, but when I was a student, 1000 rupees was a big deal for me. I still remember how I had to buy the Sony Xperia Sola and I couldn't buy the Samsung Galaxy S2 because it was priced a couple of thousand more. There is going to be a huge customer base who is going to buy the Asus Zenfone Max Pro smartphone. If you want to see a comparison between Zenfone Max Pro M1 smartphone and the Redmi Note 5 Pro, subscribe to the channel. That video will be coming out pretty soon as well. I want to talk about this one thing. If this thing happens, then I can totally justify Xiaomi increasing prices by 1000 rupees and 5000 rupees. If they keep Redmi Note 5 Pro and the Mi TV 55 inch on flash sale, like I am sure they won't keep it on open sale for a very long time, but if you keep it on flash sale, 5 मिनट तक फ्लैश सेल चलना चाहिए, एटलीस्ट 5 मिनट्स। इफ यू कैन रन फ्लैश सेल्स फॉर 5 मिनट्स, देन 1000 rupees प्राइस हाइक इज टोटली जस्टिफाइबल, एंड इवन आफ्टर द प्राइस हाइक द डिमांड इज गोइंग टू रिमेन द सेम, पीपल आर स्टिल क्रेजी अबाउट द रेडमी नोट 5 प्रो, एंड आई कैन श्योरली अंडरस्टैंड वाई इट इज, बिकॉज द डिवाइस इज एक्चुअली ग्रेट एंड इट्स टोटली वर्थ बाइंग। माई रिव्यू ऑफ रेडमी नोट 5 प्रो इज लिंक्ड इन द आई बटन ओवर देयर और इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स एज वेल, so do check that out. The device is obviously great, it's justifiable at the price of 15,000 rupees, but for people who are conscious about their budget, this is a pretty bad deal. Now let's talk about one thing which is coming on the Redmi Note 5 Pro, that will be dual VoLTE, which will be available with the Android 8.1, MIUI 9.5 most probably. So that will be coming to Redmi Note 5 Pro. If you think that dual VoLTE feature is worth 1,000 rupees, then you may justify that pricing in your mind, like, okay, that's worth it. By the way, I want to know one thing. What do you guys think about this price hike? Whether it's worth increasing prices or not? If they still keep it on flash sales and if the device still goes out of stock within seconds, is it worth increasing prices or is it worth increasing prices if they keep the device on sale for at least 5 to 10 minutes? Is that worth it? And will you still prefer the Redmi Note 5 Pro over Asus Zenfone Max Pro smartphone? Do let me know about that in the poll over there. And will you still prefer the Mi TV 55-inch 4K HDR TV over other VOO or TCL TVs, which are like similar when it comes to features and when it comes to TV panel and all other things? Let me know that in the poll over there as well. If you have any more thoughts or suggestions, do let me know about that in the comment section box below as well. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up. If you are not subscribed to the channel yet, then click on my face right now and get subscribed, because many more awesome videos like this are going to come real soon on the channel. So yeah, thank you guys. Thank you for watching.